Pain at the pumps yet again. Oil prices are headed higher for the 10th straight week. Estimates show diesel prices could go up by as much as 60 centavos, while gasoline prices may see a 10 to 40 centavo markup. As for kerosene, prices may go up by at least 20 centavos. Since July 11, diesel prices have risen by 14 pesos and 40 centavos, gasoline by 9 pesos and 65 centavos, and kerosene by 13 pesos and 74 centavos. Banco Central Governor Eli Remolona asserts the Philippine Central Bank is in good financial shape to contribute dividends to the controversial Maharlika Investment Fund. Andrea Taguines reports.
The Banco Central ng Pilipinas can afford to contribute dividends to the Maharlika Investment Fund. That's according to BSP Governor Eli Remolona during an online interview with a local broadsheet Friday. When asked if he was worried that contributing massively to the fund could weaken the BSP, he said the BSP is in very good shape and it can afford 2 years of dividend contributions. In fact, he said they already released 31 billion pesos in initial contributions. Remolona is also optimistic the Philippines can still hit the lower end of its 6-7% growth target for 2023, despite what he described as a surprisingly low second quarter GDP. He attributed this to government underspending. But if the Treasury Bureau and the Finance Department would succeed in addressing this, he believes a 6% growth is still feasible by year-end. Remolona said they will be taking the GDP as well as the inflation numbers into consideration during the Monetary Board's next policy meeting on September 21. If inflation continues to be an issue, Remolona said they could further raise interest rates from the current 6.25%. But aside from monetary measures, he urged government to act as well by importing certain commodities in the right amounts to mitigate any more supply-side shocks. Inflation in the Philippines rose to 5.3% in August, driven by higher rice and vegetable prices. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine authorities have begun distributing cash aid to local retailers affected by the price cap on rice. Social Welfare Secretary Rex Gatchalian, together with agriculture and trade officials, led the payout at Commonwealth Market in Quezon City. The cities of Caloocan and San Juan have also kicked off aid distribution. Hundreds of eligible local vendors are expected to receive 15,000 pesos each. Meanwhile, those who are not included in the list may also file complaints in the grievance and information desks set up in the markets. The government expects to dole out about 8.8 million pesos in cash assistance on the first day of the distribution. An agricultural group believes the commotion triggered by the government's price ceiling on rice is now subsiding. SINAG President Rosendo So says the rice situation in the country has become normal. He is also optimistic prices of rice could hit below 45 pesos next month amid harvest season. Despite criticisms of the measure, SINAG believes the price cap will have little effect to local farmers due to the previous subsidies given by the government. But the group also admits some farmers have yet to receive this aid.
Yun ang hinihingi natin sa Department of Agriculture, pabilisin yung proseso ng pagbigay sa magsasaka. Ay sa pang hinihingi natin ngayon, kasi last year ang rice tarification law, no? RTL, na kolekta ng almost 22 billiones. So yung 10 billion na allocate yan sa farmer machineries, etong seeds, no, and Testa, tsaka yung land bank, no. Pero another 12 billion ito is dapat mabigay sa magsasaka ng cash na 5,000 per hectare. Hindi pa naibigay ng DBM sa DA. So dapat may bigay na ito kasi imagine na nandyan yung batas, dapat implement ang batas para at least may bigay sa magsasaka yung pera. Na in which ito is malaking tulong ito.
The Food and Agriculture Organization says global rice prices have reached a 15-year high in August. The United Nations Specialized Agency said in a monthly report, while global food prices eased during the month, the price of rice rose 9.8% month-on-month. FAO attributed this development to India's ban on exports of non-basmati white rice. India, which accounts for more than 40% of all global rice shipments, announced the curb in July. Progressive lawmakers from the Makabayan Bloc slamming House Appropriations Committee Vice Chairperson Stella Kimbo over her claims that the transfer of funds from the office of the president to the vice president was illegal. In an interview with ANC, Kimbo claimed the 125 million peso fund transfer between the two offices was allowed by the current budget rules. She added, interagency transfers are normal and are reflected in the national expenditure program. But ACT party-list representative Franz Castro asserts the move was unlawful. She also accused Kimbo of misinforming the public through her statements. Kabataan party-list Raul Manuel, meanwhile, slams what he calls railroading of the president and the vice president's budget during the House deliberation.
Itong parliamentary courtesy ay ginagamit lang para hindi pasagutin ng mga tanong ang OP tsaka OVP. Matapang sila sa labas ng mga budget hearings, kayang maglabas ng mga statement before and after the budget hearing. Pero during the budget hearing, timing lang naman sila to save themselves from the risk of uttering any remarks na pwedeng or dun sila sumabit ano sa kanilang mga sinasabi. Kaya sa atin dapat hindi nangyayari yung pagtakip sa kanila through parliamentary courtesy, lalo ngayon na para bang uhaw na uhaw sila sa confidential or intelligence funds.
Students in a school in Batangas were sent home early on Friday after over 30 students experienced chest pains and difficulty in breathing due to a thick volcanic smog from the Taal volcano. According to Batangas PDRMO, several students were brought to a health center after experiencing stomach pains. Officials say they've been receiving reports of Taal spewing sulfur dioxide since Wednesday. The PDRMO, meanwhile, assures residents measures are in place to address the situation.
So we have advised the MDRMOs of the different municipalities na gamitin po ang N95 as much as possible. Ngayon po, meron naman po kaming nasa sa municipalities. So pwede na po yun na nila yung pamigay at i-replenish po namin. And this is in coordination also with our OCD.
RDC Rail Marine Services, the owner of the tanker that capsized in Oriental Mindoro and started a far-reaching oil spill, has yet to help in cleanup operations there. That assertion coming from the mayor of Pola, one of the hardest hit areas in the environmental disaster. This came even after the tanker owner vowed to work closely with the government in the oil spill response.
Wala silang tulong doon. Ngayon ang tumutulong sa atin, yung IOPC. Baka nahihiya. Pero final naman yung case para at least tumulong sila. Hindi tayo obliged as local government dapat na gumastos. Dapat kung sino gumawa ng problema, sila yung unang-una gumawa ng paraan. Kaya lang hindi sila gumawa ng paraan, kaya pinailan ng case.
Mayor Cruz also thanked the International Oil Pollution Compensation, which provided cash aid to fisherfolk whose livelihoods were affected by the disaster. IOPC has said it can provide up to 15.8 billion pesos to fishermen affected by the oil spill. The Internal Affairs Service of the Philippine National Police recommends the dismissal of 8 cops over their involvement in the killing of 17-year-old Jemboy Baltazar in Navota City. 2 of them were team leaders who were found liable for grave neglect of duty for failing to supervise their team during the operation. Meanwhile, 6 team members admitted to opening fire at Baltazar and are now facing charges for serious irregularity in the performance of duty. Baltazar was killed last month after police mistook him for a murder suspect. A senior citizen has died after being hit by a car allegedly driven by a counselor in Binangonan, Rizal. Ara Perez has the story.
Husband and wife, senior citizens Enrico and Anna, were supposed to migrate soon to Canada. But Anna was not able to make it after dying in a vehicular accident last August 6 in Binangonan, Rizal. What hurts Enrico the most is that he witnessed the accident.
Pauwi siya, ang bahay po namin just across the street. So nung pag-uwi na, tatawid siya. My mother is, yung asawa ko, napakaingat magtawid yun. Nasa middle of the road na siya, kitang-kita ko po, yung sasakyan, napakatuling. Paglingon ko ganun, nakita ko yung asawa ko nasa gitna. Kako lang, hindi siya nakatawid kagad kasi mayroon incoming ding kotse. So, nakita ko na lang, basta na lang nabangga yung asawa ko sa likod.
The driver of the vehicle being accused by the Yap family is Binangonan Rizal Councilor Jerome Antiporda. After attending the preliminary investigation of the case in the Provincial Prosecution Office of Rizal, the lawyer of the Yap family showed to ABS-CBN News the CCTV footage that they supposedly obtained from a concerned citizen. Here, it can be seen how the car hit a pedestrian who was right in the middle of the pedestrian lane. But according to the Yap CAP, this was not what was manifested in Antiporda's counter-affidavit.
Sa amin pong mabilisang pagbabasa, ang lumalabas po doon ay hindi siya ang nakabangga. Sinamba po namin sa kanya ay reckless imprudence resulting to homicide dahil namatay po si Ana. Reckless imprudence resulting to damage to property dahil nabangga po niya at nasira yung Manila water pipe. Sinampaan din po namin siya ng abandonment of victim dahil umalis po siya dun sa lugar ng pangyayari.
Hindi na siya namin makontak, hindi na siya nakita dun sa scene. Hindi rin siya nag-reach out na sa amin noon eh. Hanggang kinabukasan, tawag kami ng tawag, wala na talaga eh.
Antiporda personally appeared at the fiscal's office but he declined to give a statement. His lawyer also declined to divulge details on the case.
We filed our counter-affidavit together with our witnesses. Generally, we cannot comment on those factual circumstances. What I can say is that whatever happened to the demise of the woman, it was not an intention.
The lawyer stressed that his client was not speeding and that he was not under the influence of alcohol.
Categorically, we stated that from day one, si Consihal was not drunk. Not even a glass of beer or alcohol at the time of that incident.
Was he driving too fast, sir?
That matter also is also part of the defense, but categorically will tell you that si Consihal has been driving all his life moderately and a defensive driver at that. And even the location of the incident would not allow for fast driving because it's a busy street. It's located in so many subdivisions and many establishments. So it's a populated area. Definitely, that is not possible.
Meanwhile, LTO Chief ASEC Vigor Mendoza II is waiting for the report of the LTO Calabarzon on the accident.
When death and injury is involved, no? Ang general po dyan, isi-show cause po namin yan, okay. At preventive suspension kagad po yan. Pero yung penalty po kasi ayon sa batas, and maybe this is where we will make representations to Congress, no? Hanggang 4 years revocation lang in case of death or injury. So there's no perpetual disqualification.
The statement of the Rizal PNP Public Information Office is still pending while waiting for the complete details of the case. Binangonan Mayor Cesar Inares is leaving it up to the municipality's vice mayor to decide on any action on Antiporda as the vice mayor directly supervises the councilor and the case is already with the court. The public officials camp said they are ready to settle while the victim's family is adamant to pursue the case.
We really want an amicable settlement, if possible. Possible.
So you're leaning towards her sa settlement?
If possible, yes, we're open to that. For the record, as early as the night of the incident.
Harapin na lang niya yung kaso, panindigan niya kung ano yung nagawa niya. Kasi yung nagawa niya, hindi lang isang buhay ang nawala eh. Yung buong buhay ng pamilya namin nawala.
The Yap family is calling on the national government to act on the apparent successive vehicular accidents and road rage incidents which have shattered many lives. Ara Perez, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippines encountered yet another harassment and dangerous maneuvers by the Chinese Coast Guard during the latest resupply mission to the BRP Sierra Madre at the Ayungin Shoal. despite challenging circumstances. Manila successfully conducted the resupply mission. This is the Philippines' third resupply for Navy personnel in the lone outpost at Ayungin since the Chinese Coast Guard fired water cannons at a resupply contingent in early August.
From what I saw also, we can say that our Coast Guard and our Navy personnel behave in a very professional manner. What is important right now, as of this very moment, is that we are able to bring the necessary supplies to our people stationed at BRP Sierra Madre in a safe manner without causing injury or incurring injury in the process.
Senate President Zubiri quickly lashes at China for conducting dangerous maneuvers to the Philippine resupply team, which was on a humanitarian mission. Zubiri says only barbarians will be delighted at seeing soldiers being denied food. Senator Francis Tolentino, meanwhile, says the Philippine government should continue to strengthen its ties with other nations.
Hindi naman po pwedeng palagi na lang at patuloy yung paglabag ng China sa international law. So tama po yung ginagawa natin ngayon na makipag-alyado tayo sa international community na sa ganun matigil na po ito. Pinapahirap nila dahil doon sa dangerous maneuvers nga.
This comes after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged members of ASEAN and its trading partners, including China, to exercise self-restraint and refrain from unilateral and assertive activities that would increase tensions in the region. The president also scorned dangerous activities in the disputed waters. The Chinese Coast Guard calls the latest resupply mission an illegal intrusion of Renai Reef. China says the Philippine vessels enter the waters of Renai Reef without permission from the Chinese government. It claims Beijing has indisputable sovereignty over the Nansha Islands, which is internationally known as the Spratly Islands. The Chinese Coast Guard asserts it will continue to carry out law enforcement activities in the sea under China's jurisdiction.